Today we're going to talk about how to install VS Code on your Windows 10 computer. So to do this, for PlatformIO, what we first need to do is download VS Code. So in your browser, type VS Code download. And then click on the very first link. And over here, it shows the download for Windows 10. So click on that. Now this may take a few moments to download, which is okay because most of the world has pretty good internet, I hope. So as soon as it's finished, what you're gonna do is you're going to go to Show in Folder. You're going to double click on this and you're going to accept the agreement, then click next, then click next again for the directory. It's the default for your computer, and then next again. And then of course, add to path is already checked, so you don't need to worry about that. But if you want to create a desktop icon, you can always click right here and then click next, and then finally install. Okay, now that it's finished, we're going to launch Visual Studio Code. And once this is open, what we want to do is first familiarize ourselves with what we have here. So we have the Explorer, we have our Search, we have our Source Control. This would be something like Git if you're using it. Then we have our Run, and then we have Extensions. So what we're most concerned with right now is extensions. So we're going to click on that and we're going to type PlatformIO and the very first one that's 1.10.10, we're going to install that one. Now this may take a few moments and what may happen down here is that it's going to install your C and your C++ extension. So that should be automatic now in VS Code when you're installing PlatformIO. Now this part may take a few minutes depending upon your computer. You're going to have to leave that up and running. So while that's occurring, what I'm going to do is go to the browser and I'm going to download Marlin. So it's MarlinFW.org and then press enter. Of course, if I have the right website, that would work really well. And you're going to click on the download selection and we're going to download the version for 2.0.x for the zip. This is good for both 32-bit and 8-bit processing. Now with VS Code using PlatformIO.ini, you can also compile your 1.1 as well for something if you have like an 8-bit processor. But we're going to grab this for now. So while that's downloading, I'm going to go over to VS Code and check on it. And it says that I need to restart it. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to close it and I'm going to reopen it. And we should, in theory, have PlatformIO installed now. So while that is coming up, I'm going to go back to my download folder and unzip the Marlin folder by doing Extract All after I right-click. Then I'm going to click the Extract button. And this may take a second, so let's go back and check on VS Code. So with VS Code, we have something here that is on our first selection, which is the Explorer. And what this does is allows us to open a folder. So in the case of Marlin, for the firmware, we have to actually open a whole folder. So I'm gonna click on this for a second to show you it. This is actually Marlin 2.0 that's already been unzipped. And then there's another folder inside right here. That's what we're interested in. So I'm gonna close this for a second. Then I'm going to click on open folder. And I'm going to go to my downloads folder, Marlin 2.0. Then Marlin 2.0 again. And I'm going to say select folder. So this should bring up our environment for setting up the compile. There are various ways to compile. It's also known as build. So if you look down here, there's a little checkbox that says PlatformIO build. And then there's the normal PlatformIO upload. That means that you have to have your board connected. But in this case, we don't have our board connected via USB. So we're going to skip that for now because I want this to be as generic as possible. So to start with, I need to explain some things about Marlin. Inside Marlin, there's a folder that contains all the information you need to compile your actual build. And what we're most interested in initially is configuration.h. Inside configuration.h, I'm going to do a search on motherboard. And I want to show you that the default motherboard is board underscore ramps underscore 14 underscore EFB. And that stands for extruder fan bed. Now that's the default configuration as it comes. The other thing that you're concerned with when using platformio.ini over here is that you have the correct environment. And what I mean by that is this is the actual chipset that's on the board so that it can compile. In this case, it's using a Mega 2560. So that's the chipset that we're going to be using by default. So in order to check to see that our build is good and that VS Code with PlatformIO with its extensions does work, we're going to click on the checkbox right here to do a build. So this may work on the first try for most people, but I've seen instances over the last couple of days when I've been playing with it that it doesn't always work the very first time. So my hint is try a second check if it doesn't work the first time and you get a failure. So now that that is almost built, we'll see what happens here. So as you can see, it's compiling as we speak. And right now it's doing a lot of hardware extraction or hardware abstraction layer. That's what HAL stands for. And now it's nearing completion. So any second now it's going to pop on this computer as compiled. One of the things you may notice is that there's a .pio folder. This is where your actual build will go. So if you go to the build folder and then Mega 2560, it will appear in here. But for this particular build, it's designed to upload directly to the board, so it's not really that important. But at least you know now that Marlin is functionally working. So I'm going to show you an example of another board that's actually 32-bit versus the 8-bit that I just showed you. So I'm going to click on configuration.h. And I'm going to go to the boards again, but because we already have one board type here, we need to find our board. So I'm going to click on the source folder, then the core folder, then boards.h. Inside boards.h, I'm going to do a search on SKR and see what we find. So as you can see, there's the board underscore bigtree tech underscore SKR underscore V1. Underscore 4. That's for the regular Bigtree Tech SKR. If you wanted the turbo version, it would be down here. But keep in mind that there's different chipsets. So the list with the turbo version is an LPC 1768 for the default environment. Whereas this one right here that we're going to copy, the default environment is LPC 1768 for the default environment. So keep that in mind with your chips, what you're working with for your chipsets. So I'm going to close out of this and I'm going to go back to configuration.h and I'm going to click on that and then I'm going to paste right here our board type. Now because I've changed the board type, it's going to have the different environment. So in this case, this is going to be LPC1768. So this may also have issues compiling the very first time. Keep that in mind, but always try a second time before you think there's something wrong or you make modifications to your configuration.h file or your configuration_advanced.h file. So let's see what happens here. So right now it's probably looking for some information. It's probably downloading the framework that it needs to work with for this particular chipset. So this is automatic because it's already set up in your PlatformIO.ini. So these are all outlined for things that it should grab. So it makes configuration very easy for you to set up and actually work in your environment. So as you can see, there's a lot of different boards specified. Your board probably exists, but the quickest way to check, obviously, is to go to source for boards.h. And inside here, all the boards that can possibly work with a 3D printer that they've figured out for Marlin will be listed. So this is rather helpful. If there's a board that doesn't exist, maybe you can get into figuring out how they set up the pins file. So while it's still compiling, I'll actually show you what the pins file looks like. So it's source, then it's pins. And then it's broken out by chipset down here. So the ramps would be something, for instance, right here. This would probably be your 18 Mega 2560. And in the case of the ramps, there's probably multiple versions because there's an older version right here for backward compatibility. And then there's the newer version, which would be this. And what this is it explains how the pins are connected around the board and what their functionality would be for your particular configuration. So that all you have to do is do the settings in the configuration file. So now that we understand all of that, this compile should be close to completion, which it is. And we can check it to make sure that it's successful by finding our chipset, which is right here, which is the LPC1768. And we can also check up here for build. We can actually go to this folder, right click, and then go to reveal and explore. So if you open up this file, the file that we're interested in is that one. That would be firmware.bin or our binary file that we can copy over to our configuration and then power cycle, at which point it will point to it on your 32-bit configuration in your micro SD and install it. It will then rename it as firmware with all capital letters .cur, which I believe they call current. And if you ever wanted to reload that firmware again, you'd have to rename it back to this right here, firmware.bin, and do another power cycle. And it will then basically install your firmware and rename it .cur with all capital letters. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.